Hey ladies, welcome back to my channel. Let's get into the summertime fine orange glow. Now I went in with my Grwm glow, and then on top of that Grwm glow I used my Becca Ever Matte, and of course I know I put some powder on top of that. I didn't get the powder on camera for some reason, but yeah, I put some powder on top of that, and then I went in with my Becca Velvet. So then we're going into my favorite palette, my Morphe palette, and going in with this red color as our transition color. And then we went back into the Morphe palette and went in with that brown color and put it in as our crease color and blended out again with our transition color. To take our blending brush and make sure all those colors blend in together. Now I didn't do a super full eyeliner look. I just took a brown eyeliner and shaped it a little bit. So then we're going in with our Fenty foundation. Again, helps control our oil. Then I'm gonna use my favorite beauty sponge that I got from Walgreens. Again, I tell you this all the time. Got it from Walgreens for like $7. And we're going to blend that foundation out. So on top of my Fenty foundation, I've been doing this for the past couple of weeks. I've been putting my Born This Way extended Jackieina foundation on top of that. This again foundation is Spice Rum. Love this foundation. It is so beautiful. And again, blended it out. Make sure you get under them eyes, like the thinner part of the sponge. I use that to get under my eyes to make sure my entire face gets covered with makeup, because sometimes I miss that spot. So yeah, blend as much as you can, and make sure you get those ears and under that neck too. So then we're gonna go back in with my Born This Way, and I believe this color is Chestnut, the concealer, and we're going to put that under the eyes, the nose, the forehead, right above the lip, the chin, in a straight line by our earlobes. And then I'm going to use my brush. And I was grooving. I'm going to use my brush. And I am going to push that product in. Again, do not swipe. Push it in. Now, I know it looks a little cakey right now. But to control that cake, I always go back in with my wet sponge and push it in some more. But I like the way this brush gives me the finish that I'm looking for. Because I want it to be like really glamour. And it gives me that nice glamour look that I'm going for. But don't worry about the corners, your tear ducts and stuff like that. You can definitely go back in with your wet sponge, that small corner of that wet sponge, and push that product in some more to make sure it's blended in really well. I always tell y'all the key to perfect or beautiful makeup is blending. And I am blending my life away. I just love that brush. It just does everything for me. And you see how, if I didn't want to go in with a contour stick, that's what I was showing you guys. Being dark skinned, we naturally have a contour. So So if you don't want to contour, you don't have to. I naturally already have a contour. I just like putting the contour in because I like a little more of a dramatic look. So my Fenty contour stick is almost gone. I need to go get a new one. But I love this contour stick. It is everything to me. So we're going in with the contour stick, contouring the top of our ear. You see, I didn't bring it all the way down because this product spreads pretty well. So I've learned not to bring it all the way down anymore because it's going to naturally, you see how it's spreading? It naturally spreads. So I don't have to bring it all the way down because when I bring it all the way down, I end up with too much product and I had to put in more work just to blend it. So just a little dot right above the ear and bring it down a little bit is more than enough product that you need. So I'm going in with my Cover FX and using that translucent deep powder and putting that everywhere that I put my concealer to set it so my face won't move. And yeah, to help control those oils again because yeah, can't be summertime fine and you look like you got a box of chicken on your face. So I'm going back into that Morphe palette and there's this orange eyeshadow that I'm actually using as a blush. So it did pretty well. I actually like it. It gave me a nice color payoff. Cheeks look all nice and rosy. Yeah. And then going back into that Morphe palette again, that gold color that we put on our tear ducts, I'm actually going to use that as my highlighter with my Big Fan Fluffy Brush. And again, it did really well as a highlighter as well. So a lot of your products you can double use. Don't think, oh, because it's an eyeshadow palette, you can only use it for eyeshadow. No, I use my eyeshadows for highlighters and blush all the time. It works. Do what you gotta do. If you don't wanna spend a whole bunch of money, then don't spend a whole bunch of money. So I took that same gold and used that as a highlight under my brow bone as well. And then I went back into my transition color, that red, and put that under my eyes. And then went in with my e.l.f. mascara. Then I took this Wet n Wild glitter eyeshadow and put that on my inner duct. I didn't like it too much though, y'all. So I'm gonna be honest, don't waste your money on that. It was a waste of money for me. And then I took my e.l.f. mascara and hit those bottom lashes and then of course my lashes. And then I actually put my false lashes on off camera because y'all, I struggle with putting my lashes on. I fight with my lashes all the time. But I do have these Meek lashes that I put on that I'm absolutely in love with. So then I went in with my favorite lip liner that I got from my local hair store. And it's this wine color lip liner. I knew I was going for a more nude lip, but I think nude lips look really good with a dark liner for dark skinned women. And then I have like this peachy lipstick that I got from the hair store. This lipstick didn't even have a brand name on it, so I don't even know what brand it is, but I love the color. It's like this really peachy color, and then when I blend it in with my lip liner, it looks perfect. And then I put a little lip gloss on top of it after this video to give it some shimmer. Then we hit it with that e.l.f. mattifying spray to set it. So this is the final look, ladies. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I hope I see you in my next video. Bye. Ooh, she cute.